Welcome in, guys, to another showing of Union University basketball. I'm Jackson Milner. He is Alexander Bitterling. And we're in for another showing between the Lady Bulldogs and the Delta State Lady Statesmen. Now, we had a great game yesterday. I mean, Delta State did pull it out. They are now 1-4 on the year, getting their first win yesterday. Also, Union is falling to 3-2 now in the Gulf South Conference, though. But, Alex, man, what a game we had yesterday. In the first half, kind of slow tempo a little bit, but that second half, Delta State just came out just guns are running. So what do you think they did just to propel them to that win?
Well, something must have happened at halftime, Jackson, because we saw the Delta State team come out at the third quarter, outscore the Lady Bulldogs 22-10. They were just doing everything. They had lockdown defense without committing virtually any fouls till the fourth quarter. And then they committed a couple that were almost costly to them. That big three-point play there by Williams almost cost them the game, but they ended up pulling it out. They scored just enough in the fourth quarter to win the game, and it was just a crazy game.
It was, especially from Ewing and Buford. Buford coming out of, the, like you said, that 22-10 run in the third quarter, hitting four threes, really just pushing the momentum, and then Ewing just saying, okay, I'll take it from here, and just took him to the promised land. So, but now, if you're a Union, you just lost yesterday, coming off a loss against this team, and you really need a bounce-back win today. So if you're Mark Campbell, what would you tell your team today?
Well, they've got to go back to the way they normally play. Union historically struggles in January, their first game. They're only 2-for-7 since back in 2012. So really, they struggle that first game when they get back from the break. It must be just kind of meshing with the team again. But they've got to go back to their hot hands of Lucas struggled yesterday, only 5 points, and Williams only had 5 rebounds and 11 points. Not as big of a contribution as she usually makes. So they've really got to just play better offense, less sloppy, less turnovers. Yeah. They've got to get those rebounds on offense.
Especially also Kay Punk, her first game yesterday as a Lady Bulldog, and she shot 3-for-10 from three, so better hand from that. But, guys, the last 10 months has been tough on all of us, and that includes college athletics. So now we're going to go to Steve Beverly on the latest on how the basketball program has been affected in today's time.
Well, the pandemic has done an awful lot to really mess things up in so many ways and so many different aspects of our lives. And of course, as you well know, in the basketball games that were played at Union before Christmas, there was limited seating. Well, it's going to be even more restricted until at least January the 19th. Let me give you a rundown of what that means. There will be no new ticket sales, and that includes faculty, staff, and student complimentary tickets. The reason for that, again, is because of Governor Lee's most recent COVID restrictions. Only people who have previously purchased season tickets and a limited family pass list for the teams will be allowed to attend games in Fred DeLay Gym through at least the 19th. Now, the university is going to make another announcement on fan attendance at the time that Governor Lee's order expires. And we don't know at this point what that's going to mean, whether there's going to be a continued restriction at this point, because right now there's still a lot, and I mean a lot, of new cases developing not only locally but across the state. All regular season home games will be available either on E-Plus TV6 or online at uuathletics.com/live free of charge. And you'll have links to the road games, audio and video, and they'll be available at the same link. And also, you can remember, you can listen to Union University basketball. If we're not here with you, you can listen to Union basketball on 93.1 with Gary Neese. But for right now, sorry, no new tickets, but hopefully in a couple of weeks, maybe that's going to be eased and more of you can get back out to the gym. We'll just wait and see. Let's go back now to Alexander and Jackson.
Welcome back, guys. I'm Jackson Milner. He's Alexander Bitterling. And today, guys, we're going to go right into the starting lineups for today's game. Very similar to yesterday, starting with the Lady Statesmen. We're going to have Kaylin Wilson out there with Ziara Ewing. Also, Shania Buford, number 22, and number 23, Takira Hicks. Also, number 40, Kirsten Brown, and that was round out the Delta State lineup. Now, for Union, we'll go Shanika Lucas at the guard, Sadie Nee, of course, the three-point specialist, number 24, Emily Beard, and then Jalencia Williams, the powerhouse in the paint, and number 32, Leah Cobble. So, Alex, very similar lineup to we saw yesterday, but right now Union is going to have to come out probably fast, quick, playing their game, playing their pace, So if you're Union right now, what kind of tempo are you trying to set as soon as this tip-off goes?
They've got to bring the energy that Delta State brought in the second half yesterday. Right. So they've got to come out. They've got to be chasing after rebounds, getting those turnovers. But they've also got to get the three ball back in play. You mentioned Emily Beard being the three-point specialist. She was only 1 for 4 yesterday. Now, she had 9 rebounds, so she found a way to help the team out, tying her career high there. But Union as a team was 8 for 28 from the three-point. Kaypont taking 10 and only making 3, leading the team with 15 points. I'll give her that. But you've got to be more careful with what shots you're taking. And if you miss the shots, get those second chance opportunities.
Exactly. And if you were one player on this Union team, who do you think needs to be the go-to player to start off this first half? Who needs to get going? Who needs to get the ball first?
I think you've got to go with Lucas. Yesterday, she scored a big 3 right at the beginning, then followed it up with a layup the first 5 points of the game, and did not score after that at all.
Exactly.
They switched up to having her run the offense instead of Sadie Nee. But they've got to get a way for her to score some points today because she's a big factor for the Lady Bulldogs.
Exactly. And she averages 17 on the year. She's usually their leading scorer. Of course, that dropped down to 14 yesterday. But she's usually their go-to. We saw the 3 and the quick bucket. We feel like we're going to have a big game for her. Then she just kind of slowed down. So hopefully we see her get more involved today. Now, if you're the Lady Statesman, now Ewing, of course, was great. Buford was great. So are we wanting to see similar performances there from yesterday, or do you think someone else might can step up to the plate?
I think if you're Delta State, those are the two you want to go with. Of course, the only two returning starters in Buford and Ewing, scoring 22 for Ewing yesterday with 14 rebounds, 18 points for Buford. Of course, Davis putting in the work, getting 7 rebounds.
Yep.
The team really just working hard as a whole. And if they bring that same energy today, they have a great chance of winning this ball game.
And exactly. We saw yesterday a lot of foul trouble from the Union side. They didn't get fouled until the fourth quarter. So that's the first time they got to shoot free throws. So look for them to be more aggressive this time out. Also, you have to think from the Lady Statesman side, they came out strong, came out fast. But we're going to see that today. So we're going to send it down to the court for the starting lineups and the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, Union University of the Gulf South Conference and NCAA promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated on the grounds of removal from the Senate competition. Thank you for your cooperation. At Union University as a Christian institution, we celebrate that the Bible affirms that every human being is made in the image of God, that the gospel of the risen Christ is for all people everywhere, and that His church is comprised of people from every nation, tribe, and tongue. That we enjoy equal freedom and opportunity as citizens of the United States. And we lament that human sin has wreaked havoc in our world and perpetrated violations against the dignity of other human beings. That we have not yet attained the ideals upon which our country was founded. Therefore, we commit to remembering that our first and highest citizenship is to the kingdom of God, to repentance over our failure to obey what we say we affirm about the human dignity, the gospel, and the nature of the church, to never stop striving for liberty and justice for all, to act justly and love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God. We invite all to stand for a time of prayer and standing for the national anthem. Father, we thank you for this incredible opportunity to play the game of basketball. Father, we pray that you be with each and every one here tonight and keep everyone safe. It's in your son's precious name we pray. Number 3, 5'8" senior guard from Columbus, Mississippi, Caleb Wilson. 6'1" senior forward from Natchez, Mississippi, number 11, Zaire Ewing. 5'9" senior guard from Abingdon, Mississippi, number 22, Shania Buford. 5'7" senior guard from Newark, Mississippi, number 23, Tyra Hicks. And a 5'11" junior forward from Tanner, Alabama, number 40, Christian Brown. And now for your Union University of Lady Bulldogs, step by head coach Mark Campbell, assisted by Sarah Hammond. 5'8" sophomore guard from Fort Worth, the Holiday Inn, number 1, Shane Lucas. 5'6" sophomore guard from Grand Rapids, Michigan, number 3, Sadie Lee. 6'2" senior forward from West Ham, New Jersey, number 10, Shalala Hinch. 5'4" senior guard from Dixon, Tennessee, number 24, Finley Beard. And 6'2" senior center from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 30, Valencia Williams.
Starting roster today, she's giving her first start of the season and her second game. So I'm about you, Alex, but I'm ready for this game. Can't wait to see what Union does, and can't wait to see how Delta State responds to their victory yesterday.
Definitely going to be a lot of energy in the Fred DeLay tonight, Jackson.
Yes, there is.
Interesting to see K-Punk come in for Lucas. I mean, not Lucas, Cobble, excuse me. Mm-hmm. Cobble only shot 6 threes yesterday, only made one. K-Pons didn't do too well from the three ball either, though.
Lucas, early in the corner. We saw this yesterday. Quick three from Lucas in the corner. This was literally exactly what happened yesterday. So, we'll see what they do different, though. We got to see something different from Union today if they want to pull out a win.
And if you're Bulldogs fans, you saw that yesterday, and Lucas probably got excited, but then didn't see really anything else from her for the rest of the game. So, if you're a Bulldogs fan, you want to see that change tonight.
Maybe a quick step-back jumper from the elbow, that's for Ewing, her first points of the game.
That's a player we know we have to watch out for tonight because she's going to make a big impact for the Lady Statesmen.
Yes, she is. I mean, last game she had 22 points, so expect a big outing for her. And we beard from three in the corner. She's edged off at Williams. Great pump fake. Some good early offensive rebounds. And K-Punk with the and one.
K-Punk there just showing how much of an impact she can make for these Lady Bulldogs. And Coach Campbell really showing how much confidence he has in her despite her kind of rough afternoon yesterday.
I think he's going for the height advantage right now because those are two tall players to have in the paint like that. So, as you saw, Jamison Williams getting two offensive rebounds and then throwing it to K-Punk for the easy basket. And she'll hit her first free throw of the game. And, hey, Union has their first free throws.
Something that took a long time yesterday for Union to ever get to the paint. In fact, it was the fourth quarter before they got to take any. They ended up going 7-for-7. Mm-hmm. Pretty good on the day, but
that might have been Campbell's message. I mean, be more aggressive. Try to draw those fouls because that's they didn't have that yesterday. Now let's see how the Lady Statesmen respond. We have Brown with the ball.
Keeping those fouls to a minimum, Jackson, is what helped Delta State keep this game really close. Mm-hmm. I think if they had committed more fouls early on, they wouldn't have ended up with the win yesterday.
Let's see, looks like Hicks is going to take the ball out. Let's see what Delta State runs here. She's going to throw it out to Buford. They're trying to feed Ewing, but now she's trapped with a double team. We saw this similar thing. Wilson's going to throw up a three, and it's just with the lucky bounce, rolls in for Hicks. Excuse me, Wilson. Sadie needs K-Pong. She shot 10 of these yesterday. She looks she's going to pull it again.
Wilson did not score in yesterday's game, already with 3 points today.
Here's Lucas with another three. Looks like Lucas is trying to be a little more aggressive than she was yesterday, already pulling two threes within the first couple minutes.
Lucas didn't take a lot of shots yesterday. She only took seven shots. She made two of those field goals, one of them being a three-point.
Yeah, got the traveling violation for moving right there. Try to go for the shot, but just great defense from Kay Punk and Williams. Excuse me. Yeah, that's right.
Sadie Nee once again running the offense. We saw it at the start of the game yesterday. We've seen it most of the season. But they did switch over to Lucas for the second half yesterday.
You see them, takes a hesitation. You see both of them, K-Pong with the first three of the game. She rims out. Another offensive rebound by Williams.
Williams being very aggressive so far.
Emily Beard with the three. We didn't see her much of her yesterday shooting that, but quickly hits one right there. Now puts the Lady Bulldogs up 9-5.
Beard now 1-for-2 from three. And already Union shooting a lot of threes, not really much less than they shot yesterday.
You can definitely see a different change in effort and hustle by Union. Especially Williams, already three offensive rebounds. She's really hustling down there. Quick foul there for Ewing. She'll be going to the line for the first time today.
Now Ewing went to the line three times yesterday. She went 4-for-6, which is better than her average for shooting from the free throw.
She missed the first. Now these free throws, they might seem small right now, but like we saw yesterday, free throws made a big deal yesterday. So see if she tries to hit the second one. She ran out the second one. This short. Here we go now with Union back up the floor. Oh, looks like Sadie Nee ran into her. It's a quick turnover.
That's the sloppy offense that Coach Campbell does not want to see. It cost him a lot yesterday.
That's her shot, but great block by Williams. She knew it was coming.
Williams knew if Ewing had the ball, she's probably going to shoot it.
Great forward pass all the way to Shanika Lucas, and she's now got her second basket of the day.
Up to 5 points, which is what she had yesterday in the first quarter and the entire game.
We got Buford. She's gonna give it to Brown. Ewing out looking. She's gonna post up on K-Pong. There's her shot.
Good move there by Ewing. She couldn't find a pass that she wanted, and so she just took it herself. She did that little hop spin and pulled the little jumper right there.
Just froze her defender, too. She just completely got her off guard. Now got Sadie Nee in the corner.
She was double-teamed, in fact, by Delta State, and she's still – by Union, and she was still able to make the basket.
So we're seeing a very quick baskets being traded back and forth between these two teams. Tempo's very up right now. Wilson, she had a very good look. She didn't pull it, but now Hicks is going to pull from three. She'll miss that one. She hit one yesterday.
Lady Bulldogs lead it by four. But their communication seems to be lacking as Williams misses the layup there. Ewing with another rebound. She had 14 yesterday.
Here comes Hicks. From the Lady Statesman, I got to get a quick basket right here to stay in this game. Keep the momentum on their side. Here goes Ewing again. She's getting
double-teamed nearly all day today. You can see the Lady Bulldogs just scared whenever she gets the ball.
Buford with a floater. She'll miss. Rebounded by Sadie Nee. She's going to push. Ooh, Emily Beard wanted to pull that. Draws a foul. And one by Kay Punk.
Wow, what a shot there to follow through the contact and still make it go in like that.
She had a similar shot to that yesterday. I said Kareem because she did a little fake to the right, or fake to the left, and came back right. And just, wow, right off the glass. That was a great shot by K-Pong for another and one, her second of the game.
She now has 5 points. If she makes a shot, she will advance to six.
Looks like we're going to have our first media timeout of the game, I believe. So we're going to take a quick break here, but Union 13, Lady Statesman 7.
Community leaders are talking about Steve Beverly's TV classics, but are they serious? Do they like classic TV? Do they really watch?
That's a lot of questions in one sentence, Steve.
What do they think about the host?
I don't have any clear answers to that.
What usually happens if you watch TV classics?
A very entertaining evening for people.
Watch TV Classics Saturday and Sunday at 7 on TV6.
Oh, that's a good idea.
And we're back. I'm Jackson Miller. He's Alexander Bitterling. And again, wow, what a quick game. Like we said before the break, very fast buckets. What have you seen from these two teams, Alex, that's made a difference in this first half?
Well, this first half so far has gone a lot like the first half went yesterday, the first quarter, excuse me. Union outscored Delta State 17-10. Currently, they lead it 13-7. So not a lot different. We saw Union come out very confident yesterday, score some threes early on. Lucas seemed to be tearing it up in the first quarter. And then from then on, Union just kind of died. And they were never the same team that we saw in the first quarter.
Very true. Now we're going to resume first quarter action as Jordan Little checks in. And also, let's see, I believe it is J.C. Higgins also checking in for the Lady Bulldogs. Lady Statesman is still with the same lineup. Kay Ponk will hit her second free throw of the game. She's now 2-for-2.
The Lady Bulldogs dominating so far, but we saw the same story yesterday.
Very similar story. They got up to a good start and quickly slowed down, so let's see how they keep the momentum. And here goes Wilson.
A three there.
It's actually
no
by
good.
Mackenzie Hill is actually checked in.
She just took that three there and it bounced off the backside of the rim.
Also, let's see. Here we go with Hicks.
Mackenzie Hill did not take a single shot yesterday.
She's already taken one. Looks like she's about to take another one. Great defense with the Lady Bulldogs. Forced the shot clock error.
And you've got to know how long you have on the shot clock. Hill was driving in, but she didn't even try to get a shot off in time. I think she thought she had longer time than she actually did.
Well, I'll see number 12, Cameron Davis, has also checked in for the Lady Statesman. Jordan Little way off on that attempt. We saw Davis take that hard fall yesterday.
She did, and she got right back up and got back in the game about a minute later.
Hicks trying to kick it out to Hill. A lot of perimeter passing right now.
Coach Campbell standing up now, motioning to his team.
You know, Buford, you know she wants to shoot a three again. Hit four yesterday. Hicks is going to pull the three. And she will miss.
Delta State almost had that rebound, though.
Here comes Lucas firing up the court.
Lucas missing the layup. And Union already showing a lack of effort on defense. They almost lost that rebound there. They had two players. Delta State only had one.
Yeah, with Hill. She'll pull.
She was wide open. Union had four players down there in the paint. And Delta State had four players wide open.
Here goes Lucas. He's trying to be more aggressive, but J.C. Higgins is out for three. A lot of perimeter passing. 13 seconds left on the shot clock. See what Dean's going to do.
Capon's going to drive in and spin.
And Jordan Little with an impressive offensive rebound.
She grabbed that out of the hands.
Quick layup by Sneaky Lucas. Wow.
She grabbed it right from the hands of Ewing. Great effort there.
Very quick basket.
Union leads it by 7 with a minute 25 to play. Really how we saw this last quarter go. Mm-hmm. Similar score so far, 16-9. Yesterday was 17-10.
Here we go with Buford, a wide open shot. Oh, she'll miss. But she was 4 from 8 yesterday, so look at her to keep shooting that shot. She's going to healing right now.
She had a couple seconds, and she thought, why not? I hit several of them yesterday. I'm wide open. That's not a bad take at all.
Nope, just couldn't hit it. So we got 6 like
a good steal by Lucas.
That's what I said yesterday about her. She's a very good two-way guard, and she got another steal right there.
Lucas now with 7. She only had 5 yesterday. That is a good sign if you're a Lady Bulldogs fan to see her putting in that effort, getting a steal, and going and getting the fast break layup.
Definitely more aggressive today.
And that's what Union's got to be. Delta State played so aggressive, and the Bulldogs just weren't bringing the same energy yesterday.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. I'm going to throw it to Davis. They got to Hill, and she's going to pull from 2, deep 2.
Hill 0 for 2. Yesterday, she didn't shoot a single shot.
Mark Hamill yelling as the clock is winding down. Got 5 seconds left. 1 second left. She's going to shoot. It's going to count, and she'll hit it.
She was wide open there. Good move by her to get in there and get that mid-range jumper.
Great play right there for Jordan Little. Now we have Union leading 20-9 the first quarter. We'll be back right after this break.
When I first came to Union, it was already like March or April of my senior year, and I hadn't decided where I wanted to go. I was looking at big Christian schools, small Christian schools, even state schools. I didn't want a Christian school that would just hide me away from the world and like just teach me to live within a Christian environment. If I had to sum it up in one word, I would definitely say opportunity. It's given me so many chances to be a leader in different clubs and organizations. It's given me the chance to expand professionally, to build my portfolio. It's given me a chance to pursue my own interests and passions, and it's just been an extremely encouraging and empowering environment.
And we are back after that first quarter of action between Union and Delta State. And Union quickly off to a 20-9 lead right now. And they've just been very impressive off the start, playing good defense and offense. Delta State, you know, it's very similar to yesterday, though. And I wouldn't count them out just yet because they came out firing in the later quarter. So, Alex, I mean, what do you think Delta State needs to do to get back in the game?
I think Delta State doesn't need to give up. They don't need to be too scared yet. Saw a very similar story yesterday. It was 17-10 at the end of the first quarter. So I think what they've got to do is not put their heads down, keep their heads up, keep playing aggressive, get those rebounds, put in the energy they've been putting in today and yesterday, and they're definitely still in this ballgame.
And especially talking about effort, and we really are seeing a lot of effort from Shanika Lucas. I mean, she is out on the defensive end playing great perimeter defense, being way more aggressive than she was yesterday. She only shot 7 shots yesterday in yesterday's game. So, and she's already shot almost 7 in the first half. So she's really off to a fast start. So let's see what Delta State does, though, to combat that. Here is Buford.
Lucas already with 9 points and 2 defensive rebounds, which is going to be huge like it was yesterday. A high pass there.
Angie and Duran has also checked in for the Delta Statesman. There's Duran. Cameron Davis in the post. Quick out to Hill.
Wide
She'll
open.
Shoot.
But she hasn't been able to make a shot yet today.
Leah Cobble also checking in for the Union Bulldogs. Not starting today. She's going to come off the bench, so let's see what she does. Quick legal screen right there. Yep, they're going to put the foul on Leah Cobble for the illegal screen. We got Duran up the floor. There goes Brown. We've seen this play a couple many times with Lady Statesman. Oh, great pass from Duran. She gets fouled by Williams.
Drawing the foul there is Davis. We saw her very aggressive yesterday. 6 points, 7 rebounds.
You see the Lady Statesman, they're putting the Union positions where it's really hard not to foul. And that was an excellent pass by Duran, and Williams was either give her the layup or try to stop her. And, of course, she gets the foul. Now Davis will shoot 2. She'll miss the first.
And one of the dangers of Williams' size down low there, being 6'2", is it's a lot more likely for her to get a foul called on her. She's got to be extra careful with keeping her hands straight up and not drawing fouls like that.
Now we'll see Durant shooting her second free throw. And she'll hit that one, though.
You can see the adjustment from the first one. That one went right through the hoop.
Here we go with Lucas coming to the floor. We see her and Sadie Knee always taking turns doing this. Oh, yep, there's a travel right there by Lucas.
We saw a lot of travels yesterday on both sides. This will be the first one called today.
Very interesting play. You don't see that a lot by Lucas. You don't see a lot of travels from her. Here we go with Durant up the floor. She's been running the offense the last couple possessions. She'll do the pump fake. She'll kick it out to Hill. She'll throw it.
Delta State moving the ball a lot here.
And she'll get it in. Great ball movement by the Lady Statesman right there.
The friendly bounce there too. Bouncing off the other side of the rim, coming back into the hoop.
See Lucas right here. Into Lita Cobble, going to go down to Williams. Quickly finds Jordan Little in the corner. Just rims out.
No
but
good.
Another offensive rebound from Union.
Jordan Little now 0 for 2 from the 3, 1 for 3 from the field goal.
Williams going to go to work in the paint. Just misses off the edge. And here she goes back up, trying to draw foul. Gets her own. And one from Williams. I mean,
the effort there from Williams to miss the shot, but stay with it, get the rebound, miss a shot, get the rebound, make the shot, and draw the foul. Great effort by Jalencia Williams.
This is what we saw from the Lady Statesman yesterday. They had effort, and now it looks like Union's going to try to match that today. So, I mean, it's going to be a hard game for the Lady Statesman if Williams is playing with that kind of energy today.
We talked about that being a key to the Lady Bulldogs' success, matching the same energy that the Delta State Lady Statesmen are bringing. And so far, it's paying off for them as they lead by 10.
So she has more offensive rebounds than she does defensive rebounds.
And Williams making the free throw. Not an automatic free throw shooter for sure, but she makes it count when she needs to.
Looks like she has came to play today.
She had that big three-point play with a minute to play yesterday to bring it within 1 point of the Delta Statesman.
Great defense by Williams. Now she gets a block on the other end.
Williams doing it all. She wanted that pass there.
She did. Jordan Little, I bet Williams is like, you better make this because she didn't see me.
That's one of those things where if you have somebody wide open like that and you take the shot, you better make it or you're sitting on the bench.
A great take by Little. Now Union leads 25-12. Ellen going to shoot her elbow shot.
Another rebound by Williams.
She's putting all effort in today. Who's going to go around? K-Punk is back in the game. She's going, great pump fake. She draws a charge. What a play.
Yesterday, Williams only had 5 rebounds. She already has 8 today.
Wow.
8 rebounds.
Tell you, all comes with effort and hustle. You know, Mark Campbell probably had a couple words to say to her. Now she's playing great.
I'm sure the locker room yesterday after that loss for Union was not a pretty sight.
No, I would not have even wanted to be a fly on the wall if I was in there. There's no way, but. These players, these girls know that Mark Camp wants the best out of them. He's going to demand it. So they had to come out today playing. So far, they're doing a great job, but Lady Statesmen are not going to go away. So let's see what they do in the last 7 minutes of this quarter.
And yesterday, the Lady Bulldogs didn't really play like the team they are. A much better team than showed yesterday.
Ewing with a great mid-range shot. That you know she loves that shot. She loves shooting that shot. So she gets her basket right there.
That'll bring her up to 6 points so far, leading the Lady Statesmen.
We saw a similar, like you said, we saw a very similar half by Delta State. He has a great pass from Sadie Knee to Williams.
Beautiful
wow.
Offensive work there from Sadie Knee. She realized her layup was going to be difficult, but she saw Williams, gave her a great pass, and Williams just gets it done.
Let's see what Union. How they're going to defend now because the Lady States are going to have to respond. Cross court pass to Buford. She'll pull a three. She'll miss that one. She's now 0 for 2.
The bounce there was not what she wanted to see. It wasn't a bad shot.
Jordan Lillard's going to come up the floor and fire. And J.C. Higgins with another rebound. And just, I don't know if it was a layup, but.
A rough shot there.
But how about the effort we're seeing from Union on the offensive rebounds? Once the shot goes up, they are crashing the boards. And, man, they are really out-hustling the Lady Statesmen right now.
The effort is something to be proud of if you're Coach Campbell or a Lady Bulldogs fan. So different than we saw yesterday. And it could be Delta State played a tough game yesterday, and they look a little tired out there.
Yeah. Especially with these back-to-back games, you know, all these teams are going to be taking tolls from just playing the day before and also had to make all these adjustments. So it looks like Union has made a lot.
The adjustments have been very interesting to see throughout the season so far. A team that loses the day before kind of has an advantage the next day because they know what to expect, and the winning team's going to stick with the same strategy that worked for them.
Oh, foul on Williams right there.
She commits the foul against Maxwell.
Maxwell did not play in yesterday's game, but she is here today. See if she can make a difference for the Lady Statesmen in today's contest.
She'll make the shot there.
Make her first free throw of the game. Now she's going to shoot her second.
Union still shooting 100% from the free throw line. Yesterday, they didn't shoot to the fourth quarter. They already have three today.
And she'll hit both of hers. Maxwell is 2 for 2 on free throws, and Higgins is going to take the ball out for Union. See, Mark Campbell is yelling something right now. Got about 5 minutes left in this second quarter. Union lead 27-16. Goes Higgins down to Capon. Oh, right over her head.
A rough pass there. Capon is 6'2". So to get it over her head has to be a rough pass there. You can see Coach Campbell visibly upset.
If you're Delta State, you really have to take advantage of these turnovers by Union. There goes Hicks. He's going to drive against Jordan Little. Down to Maxwell, and she's going to go right at K-Ponk and throw a roll over the backboard.
Good defense by K-Ponk. And a great job there by Higgins to realize that she didn't need to grab that ball, just let it go out and to be safe.
Here comes Sadie Knee of the floor.
Union with 27. They didn't get to 27 till the end of the second quarter yesterday.
Here's K-Ponk all the way to Jordan Little. She'll fake the three. She'll drive. Tough take, and she draws the foul.
Good job by the Lady Bulldogs to make Delta State foul early on in this game.
We are seeing a very different Union team today, more aggressive than they were yesterday. Definitely matching the intensity. Now we have a timeout. It's a media timeout, so we'll be back shortly. But Union is leading 27-16.
I am currently serving as a lower school physical education teacher at New Hope Christian Academy, which is in my hometown, Memphis. Last year of college is when I made a fresh start with Christ, and it's because of Union's community. They poured into me when I felt lost, when I felt hopeless, and they were very intentional about me, my growth, about my personal walk with Christ, and I think that was just so important. Not only are you getting high academics, but you are also getting spiritual growth, and you're getting people that genuinely care about you, see, not only in your faith, but also in your career.
And we are back. I'm Jackson Milner. He's Alexander Bitterling, and we are having a great first half, Alex. Not as similar as we saw yesterday. Similar score, but a lot more efficiency from both teams. 27-16, Union leads it. Now, for the last couple of minutes of this quarter, Alex, what do you think Union needs to do to, you know, not only remain in the lead, but remain in the momentum?
Well, they've got to keep the energy going. We've seen a lot more energy from them today than we saw yesterday. We've seen more of their key players coming into the game and making an impact. Lucas has 9 points already. Got to keep feeding her the ball. Williams only has 5, but she has 8 rebounds, and that right there is a great representation of the effort the Lady Bulldogs are putting in.
And it's really told the whole story. Yesterday we saw the offensive rebound game definitely won by the Lady Statesmen. They just are out hustling, out efforting. That's a word, I think. Union, but today they have definitely flipped the script. But talking about how they come out of halftime, they're going to show a similar story. And Jordan Little will hit her first free throws of the day.
If somebody asked me for one stat line to define the game so far, I would say the rebound game. Union leads it 19-8. Mm-hmm. A ridiculous discrepancy there between the two.
And usually, whoever wins the wins the rebound game wins the ball game. So that's a big factor for sure. Now we have Hicks come up the floor.
Delta State trusting the three ball a little too much today. Yep. Yesterday they did well getting that in the second half, but they're shooting 12%, 1-for-8 from the three-point line. They don't typically shoot many threes.
Yesterday they saw they kept hesitating to take that three-pointer, and it was working yesterday, but they might have to go to something else today if they can't get it going. Buford's going to shoot a three, but she's going to make it.
Well, it's one of those things where when you mention it as an announcer, as a commentator, the team seems to just sense that they've got to show that you're wrong.
I think they hear us. Now Union leading by 10 after that bucket from Buford. That was her first three of the day. She hit four yesterday.
Lucas driving in.
Aggressive.
She now has 11 points, double her score yesterday.
It's not even halftime yet. She's been a lot more aggressive today, and that's probably what Mark Campbell told her going into this game. Now we have Wilson.
Coach Campbell is a great example.
Tough drive of Buford. She'll draw the foul on Jordan Little.
He's a great example of encouraging players in their skill, but also challenging them to be better. And I'm sure yesterday he told Lucas, you're better than 5 points a game. Yep. You're one of the lead scorers for us. You run this offense a lot of times, and we've got to see more from you. We've got to get more from you to continue to win games this season.
Buford will hit her first. See, she goes for her second free throw of the day.
Buford now with 4 points, 3 rebounds.
She'll miss the second, go for 1-for-2.
Good job by Lucas.
What a hustle.
The effort there.
Who's she going to give that to Kay Pong? She's going to pull for 3. She'll miss that one.
That was close. And yesterday she took 10 of those shots. She only made 3, but they were all pretty close. There weren't too many off the money.
Let's see what Hicks does. About 3 minutes left in this first half. Here is Hicks again. A lot of perimeter passes by the Lady Statesman, trying to get something. Buford going to drive, try to draw a foul. And, she gets her own rebound.
The ball will stay in their possession, but she really wanted the foul there.
Try to draw something. Then she got her own rebound, so she was hustling right there. But great defense by Union. Now Ewing's going to check in for Davis.
And that's going to be the key to this game like it was yesterday. Whoever puts in more effort. Yesterday, neither team shot phenomenally. Mm-hmm. Neither team was just amazing at scoring on the day. But the effort Delta State put in was the difference.
Amy trying to go up. She gets her own rebound. Oh, no, she doesn't. Lucas grabs it. She'll come over the floor. Hand it to Jordan Little. She'll fake and drive. And pull the mid-range.
Ewing grabbing that rebound, though.
Helping Leah cobbled by the check-in. Mark Campbell's not happy about something.
Union already being much more efficient on scoring. They have 31. In the first half yesterday, they only had 27, with still 2:20 to play.
Here is Hicks. Lady Statesman just trying to close this half with something going their way, and Ewing, she might take her mid-range here.
She's double-teamed yet again.
Shot clock violation.
The frustration there from number 23, Hicks. You could feel it from up here.
You got to be careful when you do that, though. Might draw a technical foul. So we did see one of those yesterday, but it was from Sheikah Lucas, though. But
yeah, she was committing that foul there at the end of the fourth quarter. Tensions were high as they were losing a game they didn't expect to be losing. Mm-hmm. And she just was way too rough with the foul there.
Here's Jordan Little. And another travel from K-Punk. And Mark Campbell, she looked at Mark Campbell. Mark Campbell was agreeing with the ref.
He shook his head yes.
I'm pretty sure.
Not what you want to see when you're a player. Nope. When a coach of that caliber
is agreeing against you.
Yeah, not what you want to see. And see. Traveling was a curse yesterday for both teams, and that's just sloppy basketball. You can't be doing that when you're trying to make a playoff run like both of these teams have the potential to.
And especially from both experienced coaches like these. These are both winning coaches, so they know they want to see that. But quick bucket from Davis right there. Pull the lead, the gap between Union and them, 31-22.
Both of these teams outscoring their half score yesterday. Almost a steal there from Davis.
Okay, Ponk. Going to get Jordan Lewis. She'll fake, drive in. Try to go off glass, but just misses.
She was just speeding it up too much, trying to get around the defenders, and took an off-balance shot there. Quick to call those travels.
Very quick. Say knee going to check in for Jordan Little as we see Mark Campbell just quickly just scanning through all his players.
And that's what Coach Campbell does. He switches up the five on the court pretty often, different combinations of players.
Good pass there. So Lucas, she'll try to get something.
Completely shut down there by Hill. Hill did not record a single stat yesterday. Well, she had 4 rebounds, excuse me, but other than that, that was the only thing she got on the stats from yesterday. Today she's missed several shots already, hasn't made one yet. But she'll get a big block there.
Now less than a minute to go in this first half.
Wide open.
Wide open knee. Oh, she got to hit that if you get that look.
She had all day. Hicks grabbing the rebound there. We got 10 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. So Union's going to have another chance.
Davis with a very wide open mid-range shot. She'll miss, but probably will get the rebound. And she'll be fouled by Ewing.
With that much time on the clock, you don't pull that jumper. She still had like 10 seconds on the shot clock, and that just wasn't the shot they should have been looking for. And a bad foul there by Ewing. No reason to do that early on.
It looks like Capon will check out. Williams will come in for these last 24 seconds.
And so Union's got to be a lot more excited today going into the locker room with this score. Of course, yesterday, a very similar score. But Union bringing all the effort to match Delta State so far.
There goes Sadie Knee, last remaining seconds. She'll throw it to Williams. Oh, and she'll miss the look.
Good Ewing. Effort by Ewing. Preventing the basket,
it.
Getting the rebound.
Well, that'll do your halftime score. Union 31, Delta Statesman 22. Now let's go to West Tennessee this week's news break with Madeline Stegener and Muna Grace Al-Hajl.
When the news breaks out, we break in. West Tennessee Today.
Hello, I'm Madeline Stadinger.
I'm Muna Grace Al-Hajl. For months, we've dealt with the pandemic. The challenge has been with businesses, schools, churches, whether to wear masks, and most of all, people getting very sick and dying.
That hasn't gone away, but now the focus is on the vaccine. People in West Tennessee are now being vaccinated against COVID-19. The hope is that the shot will be effective.
A mass inoculation clinic brought hundreds out to the Jackson Fairgrounds Thursday. West Tennessee Today News Director Steve Beverly was there.
They came from all over Madison County. South Highland was bumper to bumper from 8 o'clock Thursday morning. They were people over the age of 75. They were coming for the most important vaccine of the century.
It was a cold day on Thursday, unquestionably, but it was warm inside the fairgrounds, and these people behind me are among the many who have come to get their shots to protect against COVID-19 here at the Jackson Fairgrounds.
West Tennessee Healthcare, Law Enforcement, and Union University's Pharmacy School joined in the effort to dispense the vaccines efficiently.
The uptake for vaccine in this age group is always good. They've lived through some diseases that vaccines were invented and created for, like polio. They know vaccines work.
Jerry Paul Joyner was one of the first to take the vaccine. He had no concerns whatsoever about the shot.
Nothing to it. Took a minion. I took a girl that put them out in the Army.
And how would you recommend this to friends of yours to do this?
Yes, I would. And I will.
It's a tedious process to prepare the doses from a vial, but the experience was important for Union Pharmacy student Ashley Mendez.
It's a big deal to be able to be a part of this. You know, this has been going on for so long, and this is at least a step forward for us being able to, you know, get over this and being able to move on and stuff like that.
For Kim Tedford, Thursday was a day of hope, of defeating the enemy called COVID.
We finally feel like we're doing something that can help slow down the pandemic.
January 28th, these same seniors return for the second and last dose of the vaccine. Steve Beverly, West Tennessee Today.
Let's go through the current order of phases for the vaccine. The first group was the frontline healthcare workers, including hospital doctors and nurses and health department professionals. This month, priority goes to people 75 and older, as well as outpatient healthcare workers who have been directly exposed to patients. That includes people in the mortuary services. In February and March, the age bracket will move to people 65 and older. During that phase, K through 12 teachers and childcare staff will be offered the vaccine. In March and April, the shots will be available for people over the age of 16 who have high risk medical conditions.
The one thing that I get so tired of hearing people say is everybody's going to end up with it before it's over, so let's just let everybody get it and move on. Let me tell you the issue with that. The issue is you may have had it and you may not have been very sick with it, but the person next to you may get it and may end up dying because of it.
Another big question is this: with the vaccine here, how long will it be before life gets back to normal? If you have the answer to that, you must have a crystal ball. That subject has been discussed by our local COVID-19 task force. The short answer is not tomorrow or a month from now, but an optimistic target is by late summer.
You hear a range from April to July. And so I think it just depends on the continued rollout and the efforts. The fact that, you know, I know that in Madison County, we're doing a fantastic job ensuring that no vaccination gets wasted. I think that needs to continue across the entire state and country to make sure that we're not throwing vaccines away because they spoil.
Let's look at the numbers as of midweek in Madison County. The number of daily cases has slowed this week, but we probably haven't seen all of the impact of people having family gatherings during Christmas. We're approaching 9,200 total cases since the pandemic began in March. People in the 21 through 40 age brackets are still catching the virus more than any other. As of Wednesday, 24 Madison County people were in the hospital with COVID. The death toll in the county is at 145. At Jackson-Madison County General Hospital, the numbers continue to be up from the second week in December. More patients are dealing with COVID across the board. The overall patient population was up to 539. That's up 4% from a month ago. The number of coronavirus patients is up to 138. That's up 48% from December 6th. 34 people are in ICU with the virus. 25 patients with COVID are on ventilators.
Schools around West Tennessee returned to classes this week. In Madison County, students are back on a hybrid schedule because of the high numbers of virus cases in the community. Some students are on a Monday-Wednesday schedule in classes on Tuesday-Thursdays with virtual studies. Others flip-flop the days they're in person and the days they stay home. School Superintendent Marlon King says the decision was easy because the health of the community comes before anything else.
I would say it's incredibly tough, but we have teachers who are committed to Jackson and Madison County school system. We have leaders who are committed. And not only that, we have parents who have been so supportive as we navigate and try to put all of this together. So
a lot of concerns have been raised about students losing ground during the pandemic era. But a local church is doing its part to help kids get extra help. We hear more from Imani Williams.
Right now, I'm at a local church that opened their doors to assist students in academic recovery, and they're calling it the Learning Huddle Hub.
What was once a room for church activities at Pilgrim Rest Missionary Baptist Church is now a learning huddle hub.
A place that is conducive to learning. Here it's a learning environment, therefore it creates that atmosphere.
Senior pastor of the church, Wayne Smith, says a former board member came up with the idea and then the church took action. Many students in the district are not familiar with virtual learning, so the church wanted to produce a place where students felt like they were still in a classroom.
So we want to make sure that if that student is to be on class, online, that they have enough time, sufficient enough time to eat and prepare for the morning class.
Students get their temperature checked eat breakfast, and then log on to their virtual classroom. Volunteers help with homework and give the students time to play games and exercise. Pastor Smith says they plan to continue this until the end of the school year. For 39 News, I'm Imani Williams in Jackson.
I'm Peter Holmquist. Jackson City Council had a light agenda for its January meeting. One item that drew comments from a woman is the proposed closing of an alley in the downtown area. The city wants to close the area between East College and East Lafayette Streets, but a woman who lives in an apartment adjacent to that alley says it will create a hardship for parking and unloading groceries. The council agreed to table the item until the next month. They want to see if city planners can negotiate a compromise. The city is planning a memorial for the late Clark Shaw. The CEO of Casey Joan Village died on Thanksgiving Eve of complications from COVID-19. Shaw succeeded his father Brooks as the guiding hand of the tourist attraction. He was on hospitality boards in the state and on the national basis. The city will give an honorary new name to Casey Jones Lane as Clark Shaw Drive.
No one will have to change their addresses for Casey Jones Drive, but we will have an honorary name change to be a T. Clark Shaw Memorial Drive. And so it's a way to honor him for his contributions to tourism in Jackson and the Old Country Store. And, you know, I think also for the long, hard fight he had to get the interchange and the red light and the left turn out of Casey Jones Village.
Next week, we'll look at how the coronavirus vaccines are being processed and whether people are reporting any side effects.
The school board moves its monthly meetings to City Hall. We'll check in on the construction progress of two new high schools.
We invite you to follow us on Facebook at West Tennessee Today. You can see many of the stories as we cover them live as they happen. Have a great week and join us again next week for West Tennessee This Week.
When the news breaks out, we break in. West Tennessee Today.
This is the face of a fighter.
I'm fighting to keep Tennesseans working.
I'm fighting for time with my friends.
I'm fighting for football on Saturday.
I'm fighting to see my students back in the classroom.
We're fighting for our small business.
I'm fighting to keep my family safe.
Whatever you're fighting for, it's time for all Tennesseans to fight back. Until there's a vaccine for COVID-19, this is the face of a fighter. Face it. Masks fight COVID-19.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
And we're back. I'm Jackson Milner. He's Alexander Bitterling. And what a first half we saw, Alex. I mean, Union leading 31-22, kind of a similar quarter and half we saw yesterday, but more efficient. But we're going to go right now to the halftime stats, and we're going to break this down. So for Union, 38% from the field, a lot better than they were yesterday, but still they know they can do better. But Delta State shooting 35% from three-point field goal range. Union 18% from three, not very what we like to see from this Union team, but Delta State shooting 22%. So neither team really shooting that well from three-point range. Free throw line, though, Union 100%. We didn't see them shoot a free throw to the fourth quarter yesterday, but a lot more aggressive today. Delta State only shooting 50%, so they look to get that up in the second half. Rebounds, Union with 23-14. I think that said a lot, especially the offensive rebound game. Turnovers, Union 6 to Delta State's 5, and Union scoring 5 points off of those 5 Delta State turnovers, and Delta State scoring 7 off of Union 6 turnovers. So, very kind of similar first half that we saw yesterday, Alex. But, I mean, Delta State, you're down 22-31 coming out of this halftime. Now, remember, yesterday we saw this team come out a completely different team we saw in the first half. So what do you think they need to do coming out of this halftime?
Well, Union's got a lot to be excited about. They've already scored 5 free throws. They only had 7, not until the fourth quarter last night. They're leading at 31-22. Last night it was only 27-21 at half. So they have a lot to be excited about, but they cannot get comfortable.
Correct.
That was the problem yesterday. They got too comfortable. Delta State continued to put in effort after effort, grabbing rebounds, getting points off turnovers, doing it all. They weren't shooting amazing, but they were able to just play hard, grit, and grind basketball and win the game. So Union's got, they have got stuff to be happy about. They're doing a lot better shooting from Lucas, 11 points. Williams has 8 boards already, double what she had yesterday. But they can't be too comfortable.
Cannot. I mean, Union, they're one of those teams that usually they do come out of the third quarter a better team. But we did see the first game of the season, they came out very slow against Christian Brothers. And now yesterday we saw a similar thing, and they took the loss. So they may have to make sure they come out great in this halftime. But Delta State, though, they also came out of the halftime hitting threes, hitting jump shots. So let's say, I'm going to predict this, let's say Delta State does a similar thing they did yesterday. If you're Union, how do you slow down that momentum shift?
Well, they can't do what they did yesterday. Yesterday, they just, it looked like they gave up in the third
quarter.
They
really did.
They were outscored 22-10, more than doubled the score. Delta State was phenomenal in the third quarter. They had so many rebounds. They were getting the three ball in play like we had never seen it before. We saw 4 of those from Buford. And Union didn't know what to do. They didn't expect a three-point ball to be played. Then they all of a sudden had to guard outside the perimeter. They weren't getting any rebounds because of the aggression of Delta State. So today they've got to expect that. Got to expect this team to come out of the locker room playing hard and playing like they want to win this game. We talked about it yesterday. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
I'll finish up real quick. Good. Go ahead.
Delta State was 0-4 at the beginning of yesterday. They got their first win. Now they're 1-4, but they're hungry for more wins.
They are. Exactly. If you're 1-4, you get your first win against a Union team that was pre-selected as one of the top teams, the top team in the Gulf South Conference. So to get not only 1 but 2 wins over Union will really push their agenda for the rest of the season. But now also, you also got to point out one thing. Ewing only has 6 points. Buford only has 4. And these are their 2 leading scorers. So if you're Delta State, how do you get these 2 more involved?
Well, they haven't had the ball a lot. More Delta State players are taking shots more than they are. So you've got to trust the hot hand. Those are the 2 players that got it done yesterday, combining for 40 points. They're the reason Delta State won yesterday. They are the single reason they won yesterday. And they've got to give them the ball, trust that they can make shots. Yeah, they took a lot of shots yesterday. Ewing took 23, only made 9. Buford took 13, only made 6. But hey, they got it done when they needed to. And so you've got to trust them, be confident in them, and give them the ball, defer to them first.
Another thing you can also point to is the offensive rebound game, besides from the players. Union leading on the offensive rebound side 9-3. So they're just out-hustling them, they're out-rebounding them. But remember, this Delta State team came out hard and aggressive as they did yesterday. So we'll see what they do today as we come back to the floor. We're going to have Sadie Nee taking to the floor with Shanika Lucas. Kay Punk is in there. Jalen Williams is down low. And Emily Beard is in the corner. And for the Lady Statesmen, they're going to go with Davis, Ewing, Hill, Hicks, and Buford. That will be their lineup.
Williams drawing the foul yet again. She does that very well, but she can't always capitalize on the shots.
And quickly, Williams already getting fouled. You know what, Union, they love getting fouled. They love getting to shoot their free throws, and they've shot 100% today, so let's see if they can continue that streak.
Now, Jackson, close game alert for the men's basketball game at Delta State. 7.5 left to play. Delta State leads it 59-58. Now, Union's still doing a great job of shooting 51%. Yesterday, as a team, they shot 60% from the field goal, 55% from the three-point. They had 6 players in double digits.
Man, you know the Union team, they got the win yesterday over Delta State. So you know Delta State's going to come back hard today, and now they're winning 60-58. So we'll keep you updated with that game as well. Here goes Buford with a 3, and she'll hit her 2nd 3 of the game.
And that's exactly what Delta State's got to do. Give it to the key players, and they're already doing that so far in this quarter.
Now she is 2-for-4 on the day. She shot 4-for-8 yesterday from behind the arc. Here we go with Union now. Still a very close game, 32-25. And we're going to throw a wild pass to Williams, but she'll get it back. She may have traveled there.
She can't get it to go, but that is a good move. Whenever they don't call that a travel, it's a good move to pull off.
Good defense by Ewing now. Here comes Delta State to close the gap.
Ewing grabbing her fifth board right there.
We'll get back to Hicks.
She was wide open from three, but she dribbled in.
You don't see that a lot. Take the mid-range. It's a very lost shot, but she'll ignore the three. She'll hit the quick two. Now it's only 27-32 Union.
And, hey, Hicks, a player that's already missed 2 3-pointers today, maybe lost a little confidence, but she knew she could drive in and hit that mid-range.
Just keep on. She'll just fire from three. She'll rim out.
And you saw that yesterday so many times. Now she's 0 for 3 today. She was 3 for 10 yesterday. And Bulldogs fans do not want to see her continuing to take those shots and miss them and giving up the ball when they don't get a deep or offensive rebound.
Totally agree on that. But she's 3 for 10. You got to know when to stop shooting. But she thinks she can hit him. She's probably going to keep pulling. But Mark Campbell, I don't know how much longer he's going to let her shoot it. See Hicks. She'll do another mid-range.
Yesterday,
mid-range
Union shot 28 3-pointers. They made 8. Today, they have already shot 12, and they have made 2. You've got to know when it's not falling for you, and you can't just continue to take shot after shot when it's not going in.
And that could have killed them this game. It did yesterday. They did not make the many threes they wanted to, and it just got them out of the game. So hopefully today's not different, the same story. And
Ewing with that one-handed rebound there, beating out Williams yesterday. That was one of our big stories of how are those two players going to compare to each other. And Ewing just outplayed Williams in every single category.
Ewing with 6 points and 6 rebounds. Williams with only, she actually has 8 rebounds, but only 6 points.
And yesterday, Williams only had 11 points, and she had 5 rebounds. Ewing, on the other hand, had 22 points and 14 rebounds.
Oh, hard drive by Sadie Nee. She'll be fouled by Cameron Davis, number 12, Delta State. Sadie Nee will shoot her first free throws of the day. You see Union way more aggressive than they were yesterday, really getting to the foul line a lot.
And Delta State committing way more fouls today. Yesterday, that's what kept them in the game. They didn't commit any shooting fouls until the fourth quarter. Tonight, already committing several of them.
There we go, Sadie Nee. She'll hit both. And now Jordan Little will check in for Sadie Nee. So the Lady Statesmen are going to take it out, and let's see if they can do. About 6 minutes, 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Oh, and bad. She knew it was a bad pass. Good thing Ewing was there.
Ewing playing very well for the Lady Statesmen. She's what got them to the win yesterday with the help of Buford.
Oh, nice mid-range. Cameron Davis, she's really coming alive in this third quarter.
And that's what happened yesterday. Delta State, everybody came alive in the third quarter. So far, they're outscoring Union.
Oh, Lucas just runs out. Yep, foot was out. And Jordan Lowe's going to take it out, see what Union tries to run right here. See Davis now with 7 points after that shot.
Buford, the only other Lady Statesman with 7 points. Not a lot from Ewing so far. 6 points, 6 rebounds. She's got to come alive for the Lady Statesman to stay in this game.
Here goes Jordan Little going to go. Oh, and Ewing saw it.
And she gets the steal there. Her first steal of the game.
And goes back to Ewing. That's her spot right there, so she can get it off, but get it back to Wilson.
It's a 5-point game, nowhere near comfortable lead for the Lady Bulldogs.
Not Ewing going to drive. Tough shot.
Surprised she wasn't fouled there. She was sandwiched between Williams and Capehaunch. 2 6-2 players, it's hard to not get fouled there.
That's an interesting lineup. I think that's what Campbell is noticing. He believes that they are hard to defend the paint, which they are. They're hard to guard, so great lineup right now for Campbell, but 34-29, still a very close game.
Two very tall players on the court at the same time gives you a huge height advantage.
It's probably points to the reason why we're winning the rebound game, but also the hustle by Union.
Some of the players on Union's team, not very tall. A three there by Kaypon. She continues to shoot.
So it's, this one guy once said, I can shoot, if I shoot five threes and I miss all five, but I keep shooting, then I'm fine. But if I shoot 20 threes and I miss all 20 and I stop shooting, I lost confidence. It's a guy named Steph Curry, if you ever heard of him. He can shoot a little bit. But she isn't losing confidence. She's going to keep shooting. But
thing is, Steph Curry, I don't think has ever gone 0 for 20.
Oh, no, I don't think. The day that happens, he'll probably retire.
The other day, he did have a rough game. I think he only had 13 points.
Last night, bounced back for a 39-point game. So I was watching that game. It wasn't looking good. But
Williams drawing yet another foul and completing the basket.
A media timeout, and we're going to have Union leading 39-29. We'll be back shortly after this break.
If you watch Steve Beverly's TV classics, you may get a snack.
What do you say we toast some marshmallows, huh?
It's with your host,
Big Steve.
Some people watch even if they don't like the host.
Big Steve notwithstanding.
What do smart viewers think?
Oh, Mr. B, you're just a doozy.
Steve Beverly's TV Classics, Saturday and Sunday from 7 to 10 on TV6.
And we are back from that small break. Union now up by 10. Very quick, a couple buckets from Union right there. And so far in this third quarter, very similar to the first half. We haven't seen really anything different from each team. But, I mean, Lady Statesman, they got to get something going before Union slips away with this. I mean, they're still within it, but coming out of this half, what are you trying to preach to that team?
Well, for the Lady Bulldogs, they're doing a great job of not giving away the third quarter. Delta State won the third quarter. It was the sole reason they won yesterday. They outscored Union 22-10. Union is continuing to score, not giving up any of their lead. In fact, adding to it at this point. And so just huge props to Coach Campbell and the Lady Bulldogs for continuing to play aggressive against this Delta State team.
And Williams going to the free throw line. She'll be shooting her fourth and fifth free throw today.
Now on the men's side of things, Union beginning to pull away from Delta State. The score 70-63 with 3:36 yet to play.
Now who's our leading scorer of that game, Alex?
The leading scorer would be J.C. Clausey with 14 points.
So very impressive.
In only 18 minutes.
14 points in 18 minutes. Wow. Very impressive game over there. We'll keep you updated on the final there. The Union starting to pull away from them. Now for the Union Lady Bulldogs, they might be starting to pull away from Delta State unless they can come up with something right now. Cameron Davis will get the offensive rebound. Was Durant back to Ewing. Might have been a travel there, but front irons it.
Williams with yet another rebound there. That'll bring her to 9 on the day with 8 points. Close to that double-double.
Great pass from Sadie Nee, but Williams just drops it. Buford going strong against Jordan Little.
She'll get the foul there, but I'm surprised to see her not defer the ball to Ewing, who was just a little behind the defenders there and could have had an easy layup.
Number 22, Buford, will be shooting her third and fourth free throw. She's 1 for 2. With 7 points today. She'll hit her first, now 2 for 3. She's also the leading scorer matched with Cameron Davis. So Ewing with only 6 points. So look to see her try to get in rhythm this two quarters in the game. And she'll hit both her free throws, now 3 for 4.
With 8 points so far on the day. She's the leading scorer for Delta State, but they've got to find somebody quickly who's going to score a whole lot of points and do it soon.
Remember yesterday, that was her yesterday. She hit the threes, but it could be somebody else today. But they definitely need a momentum score. And another travel from Kay Punk. And Mark Campbell again agreeing with the ref. It seems like she just keeps shuffling her feet.
The thing about it that time was it was on our camera, so the viewers got to see.
You saw that time.
Her look over at the bench, and Coach Campbell just shake his head and say, yes, you traveled.
Yes, you did.
And that's definitely something he's going to work with her, because she's already got two today, multiple travels yesterday.
And you know Mark Hamlet is not liking that, because that is giving Delta State a chance to get back in the game. Now only down 31-39.
When you're a team of Union's caliber and you're expected to go far in the playoffs every year, you cannot travel that often. Big rebound by Williams.
I mean, just trying to get give her something 10. Going. Good fake by Sadie Knee. Out to Jordan Little. She'll spin. Great spin. Just misses. Hits her own rebound and puts it in. Wow.
Ewing kind of tipped the ball back up, and Little was just able to grab it and put it back up for the redemption shot there.
She did not give up on the play.
Union still leading by 10.
Delta State now going to kick it out to Wilson. Excuse me, not Wilson, Hill.
Union, in typical fashion, every player that's played in this game has, a big air ball there by Brown.
So I think Williams might have tipped that one.
At least that's what Brown is going to say.
It's a good shot by Sadie Knee. Very good drive by her. Now 43-31. Sadie Knee now with 3 points. That was her first actual field goal of the game.
Delta State looking to make something happen and do it quickly. They're trailing 12.
There's Buford way off that time.
And that was not the three-point shot we saw from Buford yesterday. Not at all. She had 4 in the third quarter to just spark Delta State onto that victory.
Just a little too windy in here. Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. But anyways, Union 43, Delta State 31. Very close contest. We'll be right back after this short break.
My name is Katie McCoy. I graduated in 2007, and now I am serving at Southwestern Baptist Theological Seminary as an assistant professor of theology and women's studies. Let me tell you how Union transformed my life. I was called to ministry shortly after graduating, and when I look back, I can see how the Lord was planting seeds to prepare me for the future that I didn't know I was going to have. Come ready to see how it's all going to integrate into the big picture and overall direction of your life as a disciple of Christ. And that's my Union story.
And we are back from that small timeout there. It's 43-31 Union as we close with the last 2 minutes here. Now, Alex, can you give us an update on the men's game?
Absolutely. And we said Union had began to pull away with 3:30 to play, but now with 2 minutes to play, they're leading 72-70, only leading by 2. DeBuck with 19 points, Clausey with 14, and J.C. Hawkins with 10. Yesterday, 6 Bulldogs were in that double-digit stats, so not quite as many tonight, but still shooting 52% from the field goal and about 44% from the three line.
Very close game between. We thought they were going to pull away, and now it's only a two-point game with 2 minutes left to play. Now back to the Lady Bulldogs. They're winning 43-31. Still not out of reach for the Lady Statesmen. They know they can quickly make a comeback. J.C. Higgins not going to come back into the game. With Lucas, Jordan Little, Williams, and Sadie Knee. Statesmen still with the same lineup. With Ewing on Williams right now. She's going to try to go up. Goes around and she'll get fouled by Ewing. Ewing does not agree with the call, but now Williams going to get her fifth and sixth free throws today. She is 2 for 4 today, so shooting 50%, not bad from her. She's usually not the best free throw shooter, but today she's hitting them.
And Williams yesterday was big from the free throw line in that fourth quarter. She had the big three-point play with a minute left. But she's doing a lot for this Lady Bulldogs team right now.
And she'll hit both. She is now 4 for 6.
She now has 11 points and 10 rebounds. 3 blocks.
Great game from Williams right so far. Here goes Brown. Trying to get something going here. A lot of perimeter passes, usually what they do. Probably trying to get Ewing open. And Sadie Knee with great defense right there. Comes Buford. Crosses over. Williams is there. It's great defense from Union, shutting down anything that Delta State tried to run right there.
Great job, and I think that was another block by Williams, which would give her four. She's a big leader for the Gulf South Conference in blocks.
See, Sadie Mee going to go back out to Higgins. Going to feed Williams, and she's just rushing her shots right now. Williams is making a great game today, but she has missed a lot of her inner layups right there on the paint.
And some of the post players have a tendency to just hit it off the backboard really hard instead of the soft touch. And that's what we saw from Williams there.
She's just forcing. She's trying to go in with a lot of contact, but just forcing that ball way too hard. Ewing, she's going to spin right off the glass. Ewing now with 8 points. Trying to get her going.
Dangerous pass there, but Little was able to grab it. Some aggressive passing from the Lady Bulldogs.
Trying to get somebody over JC Higgins. She's going to drive. She's trying to draw a foul.
She'll draw the foul there, but if she had turned her head, Lucas was wide open from three.
She got the charge. Great inside play from Hicks right there. Great way to acknowledge the charge. But, man, she really did try to foul something, but Hicks was just there.
And we saw some of the Delta State players yesterday do a great job of planting their feet, taking the charge to get possession once again.
Remaining 3 seconds left.
What a shot!
Buford right up as the time is going down, hits the end one, closing this gap between Union. I don't think she's trying to – they're not giving up, man. They're not giving up.
It's within 10 near the end of the third quarter. Buford now has 11, though. Ewing with 7 rebounds, 8 points. They are still putting in maximum effort to try and stay in this ballgame. They'll keep it under double digits as we head pretty much right now into the fourth quarter.
What a way to close it out. Not only a 9-point game going into the fourth quarter, so we'll be right back with you with that fourth quarter action. Union 45, Delta State 36.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
And we are back after that quick break. Now, Alex, you're looking at the score over there. I see you're doing. It's a very close game. What's the men's game looking like?
Well, the men's game, the men's Bulldogs lead it 74-72 with 47 to play. It is anyone's game. Much like the game last night with the Lady Bulldogs here, it's coming down to the last minute of that game.
And they always say – well, go ahead.
I was just saying it could be anybody's game.
They always say it's hard to beat the same opponent twice, especially within 2 days difference. So – it's going to be very hard for Delta State Union to keep it up, but now it looks like they're leading 76-72, so they're trying to stay ahead, but Delta State is not going away. Now here, Delta State trying to get a win over the Lady Bulldogs for a second straight win, but they're going to have a tough contest to go. We have 10 minutes left, and let's see what both these teams have in store.
Now, Jackson, it's a 9-point game here at the Fred DeLay, but if Delta State has a quarter like they had in the third yesterday, they could end up beating Union.
They can. And two straight wins over Union would be huge for this Lady Statesman team.
They would advance to 2-4, which doesn't sound good, but against Union, two wins is a big counter.
Especially on their home floor. That's no easy task. Especially, we really don't see Mark Campbell winning two straight games, so this would be a huge win for them. Let's see what they do. Ewing trying to go in.
Union's lost.
Williams. Oh, she gets her own rebound off of Williams' block.
The effort by Ewing there is what's going to keep them in this game. But what I was saying was Union has lost two of its last three ball games. Mm. That is very uncharacteristic of this team.
Yes, it is. And you know, Mark Campbell is not pleased as he's signaling Emily Beard to come into the game.
And we talked about at the beginning of the season, our game way back in December, when we said that the transition from the Jada Smith era of this team to what's going on now is going to be difficult. And I think we've seen that so far. The team chemistry is not all there like it used to be. They've got good players, but they've got to find a way to bond together. How about Ewing?
She's doing everything she can in this last quarter. Drawing the foul there. She'll now go to the free throw line, shooting her third and fourth. She has not hit a free throw today, 0 for 2.
She's got 10 points now, 8 boards, close to a double-double. Williams on the other side already has one.
She'll hit the first. Make her 1 for 3 on the day.
Williams also with 5 blocks. Very, very impressive.
She just came to play today. We didn't see much of her yesterday, but today, totally different. Williams. And
she had 11 points, but not what she typically scores, and she wasn't the impact that the Bulldogs needed from her.
But today's definitely made a difference. However, Union only up by 5 now. They were once up by 10. And is that another foul on K-Ponk? Is that a travel or was it a screen?
It was a foul on K-Ponk.
Was not looking. I believe it might have been was an illegal screen.
That is her 4th foul of the game.
Mark Campbell is not pleased with that. Higgins is going to come back in.
On the men's side of things, up at Delta State, 4 to play. Union leads at 77-74. Still a 1 possession game.
There goes Hicks. Wide open Brown. And she'll miss. Oh, he got to hit those. Great look from the Lady Statesman. Here goes Lucas. She'll push it up, going right up the floor and soft touch off the glass.
Big rebound by Williams between Ewing and Brown. Gets it to Lucas, who can just run down the field and make that layup.
There was no one stopping her, going from coast to coast. Now here we go. Trying to kick it out. Here's Hicks. She'll shoot the 3. Way over, but Ewing right there for the rebound. Little's not giving up, though. And a bad pass from Little. A lot of back and forth, some sloppy basketball we're seeing right now.
For sure, and we saw this yesterday for the majority of the first half. Both teams were not looking like themselves. As Union's men complete the game, they're able to win at 79-74 with back-to-back wins. They'll improve to 4-2 on the season, beating the Lady counterparts for the Union, having a better record, not something we see very often.
We do not see usually these ladies' Bulldogs team, which I can count on is probably going to bounce back this season. But great win for the Union men's team. They get 2 wins over Delta State.
A lot just went on under the basket as Williams makes the layup here. Williams had a big block, rebounded by Higgins, stolen, put up by Ewing, missed. Rebounded by Higgins, and then in transition, Union adds the score.
I'm glad you memorized all that. That was impressive. But, man.
A lot just happened. If you blinked, you probably missed a whole lot of stats.
Williams just with a finish in the basket there, now up 49-40. Brown again open right there, but she'll do a little step back. Just misses.
And nothing you can do about that.
Ewing got hit on that play.
That's just a painful roll when it rolls out like that. There's nothing you can do, but it definitely hurts to watch as a player.
Now, Lucas, you saw her. Every time she gets the ball, she's full sprint ahead, and that's probably what's been hurting Delta State. She wasn't like that yesterday, but today she's been a totally different player.
She has 12 points on the day, 11 rebounds, and 6 blocks, and add 2 assists to that. Not a stat she gets too often. She is only shooting 4 for 12. So
I'm 4 for 12, but man.
33%, but still making a huge impact.
And Brown just takes it right out of the hands of Jordan Little. I don't know if that was a block or just, I don't know. Wow.
Delta State reminding everyone that they are far from done.
Hicks with a sweet mid-range jumper.
They'll keep it within 7. That's a 3-possession game.
4 points now for Hicks.
Still a lot of time if the momentum shifts Delta State's way.
Emily Beard with her 2nd 3 of the game.
Well, with that, Union kind of, I guess they heard me and said, well, the momentum's not shifting too much.
As I'm saying, I feel they can hear us. I think they can.
Beard now 2 for 3 from the 3-point line today. Much better than yesterday, going 1 for 4.
There goes Durant. She's going to give it to Brown and then Davis. Good floater right there from Hicks. That's another basket from her. Back-to-back baskets for Hicks. We give her 6.
And they're just trading baskets back and forth on the floor. Union still leads by 8, though.
8-point game, about a little under 6 minutes left to go.
Higgins almost lost the ball there.
Williams with a nice, there it is, right off the glass. And Mark Campbell's gonna call time after that quick basket. Now Union up by 10, 54-44. We'll be back shortly.
Is my older brother, Tom. When I would visit him occasionally, he would talk about things that didn't make sense to me. Bottom line, I got a call. And my brother killed himself. I've always felt I could have done more. I'm Mike Thompson, and I will listen.
And we're back after that short break. Union now up 54-44, where they were down. They were only up by four, then five, and now they're back up to 10. So it's like Lady Statesmen are making ground, and then Union just pulls right away. So if you're Lady Statesmen, what can you do so that the Union could not get away anymore?
Well, once they get a couple of points back-to-back, they've got to keep the momentum in their favor. Mm-hmm. They can't be giving up big threes like we just saw Beard get to bring it back up to 10, or Williams just driving in on Brown and making that easy layup as the buzzer goes off about five times there, losing the track of what I was trying to say. But Delta State just has to bring the effort. They've been doing it tonight so far. They brought it yesterday. But they've got to follow through, 5.5 to play. Give your 100% and try and win this ballgame.
It's going to come down to who wants it more in this last quarter. You know, the Lady Statesmen, we saw it yesterday. They wanted it more. But Union says, hey, I don't think we want to lose two straight games, so let's see what happens. And we're still trying to figure out something with the scoreboard here. So our officials are talking right now, trying to figure out what's going on.
I'm anticipating a couple more buzzers before.
I am too. Give me one more.
Looks like we're all good.
All right, never mind. All right, Duran's going to take it up the floor for the Lady Statesmen. About 5:30 left in this game.
Union's defense there just clamping down.
There goes Davis trying to find somebody.
Trying to get it to Davis down there, but she gets locked down between me and Williams every time she gets the ball.
I don't know what. Well, it's a quick crossover, but stumbles to the ground. Duran trying to get back up the floor. Sadie Need to Emily Beard, and she'll hit again for her third.
Emily Beard, 3-for-4 today. She was 1-for-4 yesterday, and she's a big reason Union's doing so well in this quarter so far.
She keeps hitting those. That lead's just going to keep growing. So if you're Lady Statesman, you got to get your put a hand on her. Now Davis, she'll shoot a mid-range. She'll miss. Rebound goes to Sadie Knee. Emily Beardy, you know she wanted to shoot that.
Down to Williams.
This is off the glass again. We've seen that. That's been a story for her. She has made a big impact in this game, but she's missed a couple easy layups. So
she does a great job of when she misses a layup to grab the rebound
quickly
and either get fouled or just keep shooting until you make it.
She doesn't give up on a play. That is one strength of hers that Mark Campbell has really enjoyed her being on this team.
Of course, she was a player that was named in the preseason Gulf South Conference polls as someone to definitely expect to be a big impact to their team. And she's done just that this season.
Now Williams going to go to the free throw line. This will be her 7th and 8th. She's shooting 4-for-6. Oh, it just rims out. We've seen a better free throw performance from her today. So much better today at the line, even though she does miss that one. She is now, I believe, 4-for-7. She'll go 4-for-8. Now I cursed her. I had the announcer curse.
Delta State speeding things up. They were trying to catch Union lacking on defense, but it didn't work out for them.
She's trying to bring this within at least 10. Looks like they're trying to go for but good hands by Higgins. Up to Lucas. Back at Emily Beard.
Count
for her
it.
Fourth. Count it.
4 for 5, shooting 80% from the three today versus 25 yesterday.
Hey, I'm telling you, when she's hitting, there is no stopping her. She is a flamethrower when she gets going.
Union up 16 with 3:40 to play. A comfortable lead, but not too comfortable.
Buford in the corner, she's short. It's a foul on Lucas.
Lucas being a much bigger impact to this team so far today. 5 assists, 4 rebounds, a steal, and 13 points for her versus 5 points yesterday.
Totally different. The three-point ball has been completely different today for Union. Yesterday, 8 for 28, but today much better from three-point range. Shooting 6 for 16, still missed 10, but way better than yesterday.
Yesterday, Higgins, they missed 20 out of 28.
And Higgins going to miss that three-pointer. That was off the mark. You know, this Lady Stacey is not going to quit playing until that final buzzer goes off. Even though they are up 60 to 44, there's still plenty of time left with 3 minutes left in the game.
You got to give them the effort. They're doing great here to try and stay in this.
And there goes Wilson with a shot. She'll get her 3 points today.
Bring her to the lead within 14 points as they go down to Williams again. Yeah. It's almost automatic down there. Give her 16 points.
I'm glad you said that. My stats are messing up. I'm trying to. There they go. Okay. Wilson now has 5 points on the day now.
points for William, 12 rebounds, and 6 blocks.
Impressive game from Williams today. Davis will shoot the mid-range, and she'll have 9 points now.
Delta State still hitting shots within 14, but only 2 minutes to play. Not a lot of time to get it done.
So they're making those mid-range shots, but they've got to be able to stop Union on offense because Union is hitting a lot right now.
Buford and
Beard
Ewing.
For her fifth. Oh, almost had it.
Ewing with a big rebound. Oh, the steal by Higgins.
Play's not over till it's over.
And the effort we saw yesterday from Delta State, we're seeing as much, if not more, from the Lady Bulldogs today. We talked about it in the pregame. They've got to bring the same energy, the same amount of aggression, and they've...
And one from Lucas, and you're completing that sentence about effort and hustle. There she goes right there, being aggressive.
Lucas, a whole different player today than we saw yesterday. Back to her normal self.
She now has 15 points and 5 rebounds with 5 assists. Yeah, she's definitely made a difference in this game.
She only had 5 points yesterday as that bounces out.
She missed the free throw.
3 Union players now with double digits. 16 for Williams, 15 for Lucas, and 12 for Emily Beard.
Buford now shooting her three, and she'll make it.
And Buford came alive from the three yesterday. Today she's only 3 for 8. She'll get up to 15 points now, though.
And she's been the big go-to like she normally is. Her and Ewing are the main scorers, so. Trying to get going these last couple seconds, but it's going to take a miracle to get it out.
To Williams again. And at this point, there's almost nothing they can do. They virtually shut down Williams yesterday.
Yep.
She only had 11 points. She only had 5 rebounds. And today it's just totally different.
She is hitting from all marks right now. It's just that pass right over Ewing that she can just not get to.
18 points for her, approaching that 20 mark, and 12 rebounds.
Wilson going to miss, but Ewing going to get her home. Going to get the rebound and put it up for her now one, but it might be a little too late for Ewing. But she will now score her 16th best. She has now 16 points.
And 12 rebounds. She's playing the best she can. She's doing everything she can for this team. So is Buford with 15, but the Lady Bulldogs brought the effort. They had the superior team at the beginning of this series, but it just didn't show yesterday.
Now Ewing now matches her season high. Well, not season high, but her season average of 17. Excuse me, she only has 14 points.
10 to play. This game's over.
Very over now, but Looks like Union's still trying to.
Me wanted Williams to get two more to add to it.
Why not? So now we have 15, both from Ewing and Buford.
Delta State just looks exhausted out there. They've had a tough game tonight. They pulled out the tough win yesterday, but this has just been very taxing on some of their stars with Buford and Ewing.
Buford and Ewing just trying to do what they can. They both are leading the team right now in scoring like we usually see, but it wasn't enough today as the Lady Bulldogs are going to take the second of the two games between Delta State and Union. So we'll be right back after this break, but Union 66, Delta State 54 with a Union win.
The road to national championships runs through NCAA.com and the NCAA Sports app. And whether you follow one college team or all of them, it's never been easier to get the content you want all in one place. With live broadcasts of multiple championships across all divisions. With exclusive access.
You ready to go? Yeah. And
highlights for every single championship. Stay in the game all season long with NCAA.com and the NCAA Sports app.
Oh, the more we get together, the more we get together, the happier we'll be. Because your friends are my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier. The more we get together, the happier we'll be.
It's not about where you were born. It's not about your gender. Or the color of your skin. Or whether you're rich, poor, or in the middle. No matter what you play, if you have the skill and drive to succeed in school and in sports, we'll provide the opportunity.
Steve Beverly's TV classics can cure what ails you.
I watched and it got rid of my hemorrhoids.
Staying awake at night? Just watch TV classics.
My daughter watched and she went right to sleep.
Do not watch Steve Beverly's TV classics if bites upset your stomach. Do not watch if high drama leads to emotional distress. And do not turn on TV 6 Saturday or Sunday at 7 if hillbillies give you a gallbladder attack.
Ask your doctor if Steve Beverly's classics is right for you.
With so much information on COVID-19 coming from different directions, trying to find answers to your questions can be a challenge. But we're here to help. The Tennessee Department of Health provides guidance on prevention, symptoms, testing, food handling, and more. When you visit our Office of Minority Health and Disparities Elimination page, you will see a list of resources right there in your community. Places you can contact which can help bring you and your family a little peace of mind. For more information, go to tn.gov/health.
All right, crew, let's get started.
Sure.
Don't ignore the law. You must call 811 at least 2 to 3 days before any digging project so you can avoid hitting our essential buried utilities. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811.
We're back here on E-Plus TV 6. He's Jackson Milner. I'm Alexander. And Jackson, it's time for the post-game show.
It is. And we have Union with a very good win today. They lost yesterday to Delta State, which was not what we were expecting. But we do know this Delta State team is way better than they are they've seen on paper. So you saw that experience yesterday, but today they just couldn't run with Union. Union was running at fast pace. And what do you think was the key for Union to win today that they did different today than they did yesterday?
Well, Union didn't make as many mistakes in the third quarter in the second half as they did yesterday. They had a bunch of turnovers yesterday. They couldn't get the ball to fall, and Delta State was getting the three ball yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Union had some of their key players come back in, Williams making a big effort, Lucas making a big effort, and Emily Beard was making threes. So that is what made the difference today.
Exactly. Emily Beard shooting, she had, I believe, 4 threes today. So it's a very different game Yeah, 4 for 6 from three today. We didn't see her only hit one yesterday, so I think she's the one that gave them that boost in the late quarter right there. But for Delta State, and now you're fall to 1-5 on the season. You did get a good win over Union, but you need to take what you learned from today's game, but also your win from yesterday until the rest of the season. So what would you say the Delta State team that needed to continue to do to get wins and further their better record?
Well, Delta State should be proud of this road trip. They played a great game yesterday. They were 0-4. They got their first win off of a good Union team. Mm-hmm. Played a great game. Today they played a good game too. They ended up coming short by 12 points. Not bad,
not
all
bad,
things
not bad.
Considered.
Not
they're
bad
1-4 now, or 1-5 now. But they were ranked in the preseason poll as second in the division. I think they've got a lot more games, a lot more wins coming in the future. I think they're going to be a lot better team than they showed in the past.
I believe so. I mean, they came out, as you saw yesterday, saw them having offensive rebounds after offensive rebounds. But today, just Union was out hustling them. And they'll probably take that to future games. If we can play with the same type tempo, the same type pace, then we can get the win. But I think another thing points to the Union side is when they came out of halftime, they were a completely different team. We saw Union come out yesterday kind of slow, not really playing with the pace, and not acting like they figured they had this game already in the bag and just watched it slip away from them. So what would you tell Union for future games on not to let up?
Well, I think Union's got to bring the same energy to the first game, right? You can't lose the first game and then fix it and get the second game. You want to win both if you're
correct.
A Union fan, if you're
correct.
Coach Campbell. They're the team that's the type of caliber to win the majority of their games.
Mm-hmm.
They're pretty low in the division now as they fall to 4-2 after this road trip. But, hey, they've got several games ahead of them. They've got to bring energy everywhere. They've got to trust the hot hands of Williams and Lucas and Beard and realize that they are missing Jada Smith. That's
they
a
are.
Big miss for this season. But they're slowly adjusting, getting their team chemistry, and we saw a lot of that tonight.
They do. We see a very different Union team come out of that halftime today. They were a lot more efficient, shooting a lot better. And we're still going to stay here at the desk. We have 3 minutes left to the break. So I'm going to keep talking about this game today. So in the first half, we saw Union play from a very short kind of, you know, they saw hitting field goals. They weren't really hitting a lot. But, I mean, today they started doing it. But Delta State, their two leading scorers in Ewing and Buford. Buford kind of gave them that edge in the second half yesterday, but what did you not see in Delta State today that did not give them the win? What was so different about their performance?
Well, they Ewing and Buford combined for 30 tonight. They combined for 40 last night, so 10 points lacking there. But there wasn't a lot different they played. Mm-hmm. On their side, they were still playing aggressive basketball. I mean, Ewing had 12 rebounds. They had a bunch as a team, like over 30. The difference was Union. Union was a different team tonight. They didn't let the third quarter get away from them. They were able to make their shots, play their type of basketball, and able just to get the pretty significant win tonight against Delta State.
Exactly. Now with Union, they're going to come up to the next game. They'll be going against University of West Alabama. That will be January 15th. Of course, we will not be broadcasting that game because it will be at Livingston, Alabama. Make sure you tune in for that. And if you're, let's say Mark Campbell, you told your team yesterday, hey, we need to up it up more, especially with these back-to-back games. How big of a toll do you think that's having on Union this year? Because this is something you've never seen before. They are now 4-2 in the conference, but usually we don't see them with this many losses starting off the season. So what do you think Mark Campbell is trying to tell them for these back-to-backs? How do you just keep pursuing?
Yeah, well, I think it's a difficult thing this year to have those back-to-back weekends like you were mentioning.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the first loss for Union came on the second game of a two-game series earlier at the beginning of the season. Then they lost the second game last weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And really most of their losses have come from that second game as other teams, with the exception of last night being the loss there. But seeing the other teams be able to adjust and see the way that Union's playing and what they need to change to beat them, and Union on the other side, the players more comfortable because they did get the win the night before. And so they're kind of sticking with the same game plan.
Mm-hmm.
But when the other team comes in with a very different one to combat what they're expecting, they have a lot better chance of taking home the win.
Exactly. They just need to keep that full energy the entire time. And you know Mark Campbell is definitely, even if they won this game, you know he's still going to say something to them today. But we're going to be back soon after this break. We're going to give you our halftime player or the full-time player of the game after this. So we'll be back shortly after this small break.
Community leaders are talking about Steve Beverly's TV Classics, but are they serious? Do they like classic TV? Do they really watch?
That's a lot of questions in one sentence, Steve.
What do they think about the host?
I don't have any clear answers to that.
What usually happens if you watch TV classics?
A very entertaining evening for people.
Watch TV classics Saturday and Sunday at 7 on TV6.
Oh, that's a good idea.
When I first came to Union, it was already like March or April of my senior year, and I hadn't decided where I wanted to go. I was looking at big Christian schools, small Christian schools, even state schools. I didn't want a Christian school that would just hide me away from the world and like just teach me to live within a Christian environment. If I had to sum it up in one word, I would definitely say opportunity. It's given me so many chances to be a leader in different clubs and organizations. It's given me the chance to expand professionally, to build my portfolio. It's given me a chance to pursue my own interests and passions, and it's just been an extremely encouraging and empowering environment.
I am currently serving as a lower school physical education teacher at New Hope Christian Academy, which is in my hometown, Memphis. Last year of college is when I made a fresh start with Christ, and it's because of Union's community. They poured into me when I felt lost, when I felt hopeless, and they were very intentional about me, my growth, about my personal walk with Christ, and I think that was just so important. Not only are you getting high academics, but you are also getting spiritual growth, and you're getting people that genuinely care about you, see, not only in your faith, but also in your career.
This is the face of a fighter.
I'm fighting to keep Tennesseans working.
I'm fighting for time with my friends.
I'm fighting for football on Saturday.
I'm fighting to see my students back in the classroom.
We're fighting for our small business.
I'm fighting to keep my family safe.
Whatever you're fighting for, it's time for all Tennesseans to fight back. Until there's a vaccine for COVID-19, this is the face of a fighter. Face it. Masks fight COVID-19.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
If you watch Steve Beverly's TV Classics, you may get a snack.
What do you say we toast some marshmallows, huh?
It's with your host,
Big Steve.
Some people watch even if they don't like the host.
Big Steve notwithstanding. Yeah.
What do smart viewers think?
Oh, Mr. B, you're just a doozy.
Steve Beverly's TV Classics, Saturday and Sunday from 7 to 10 on TV6.
My name is Katie McCoy. I graduated in 2007, and now I am serving at Southwestern Baptist Theological Seminary as an assistant professor of theology and women's studies. Let me tell you how Union transformed my life. I was called to ministry shortly after graduating, and when I look back, I can see how the Lord was planting seeds to prepare me for the future that I didn't know I was going to have. Come ready to see how it's all going to integrate into the big picture and overall direction of your life as a disciple of Christ. And that's my Union story.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
And welcome back. I'm Jackson Milner. He's Alexander Bitterling. We're going to give you these end-of-game stats for you real fast. We have Union 45% from the field, Alex. I mean, a lot better than what we saw yesterday. This team shot a lot more efficiently and got more points. Delta State only shooting 37%, so a little bit below 40. I believe they probably had a lot of shots there that they didn't really take. They missed some easy ones in the mid-range or easy layups. So look to them to improve that when the season continues. Three-point field goal percentage, still not really that hot from Union, 33%. But when we saw Emily Beard in that late fourth quarter, she started hitting threes, and it really changed the momentum of the game. But Delta State, 25% from three, just not – they're not a big three-point shooting team, so not usually what you like to see from them, but they did give it a shot today. Kind of helped them yesterday pull ahead, but not so much today. Free throw percentage, we have 67% from Union and 71% from Delta State. Not the greatest free throw percentage from either team, but Delta State winning that today. Rebounds 40-30. Union was just crashing the boards on the offensive end and the defensive end. They were just all over the place, and we'll dive more into that in a minute. Turnovers 12 to Union, Delta State 10. And, of course, Union scoring 13 points. They scored 15 yesterday off them turnovers, but today scoring 13 points off those 10 Delta State turnovers. And, of course, Union scoring 11 off – well, Delta State scoring 11 off 12 Union turnovers. So, very different game than we saw yesterday, but also kind of similar in many ways. I mean, the one matchup you can go to is the battle in the paint between Ewing and Jalencia Williams. So how do you think that matched up yesterday, and who won it today?
Yeah, so you're talking about two players that were named in the preseason All-Gulf South Conference poll, Jalencia Williams from Union and Zahara Ewing from the Delta State Lady Statesmen. And yesterday it was all Ewing. She had 22 points. She had 14 rebounds. Williams, in her own respect, had 11 points, 5 rebounds, but wasn't the impact the Lady Bulldogs needed. Mm-hmm. Now tonight, you reverse that. Williams had 18 points, 12 rebounds, 6 blocks, and 2 assists. Now Ewing had 15 points of her own, 12 rebounds of her own. So these are two players I would go ahead and say are going to be all Gulf South Conference players at the end of the year because they're playing phenomenally for both of their teams.
Absolutely. We saw Ewing definitely winning the matchup yesterday. She took advantage, basically quieting Jalencia Williams down only for 11 points, but only 6 rebounds. So not a big game for her. But today, like you said, completely different story. 6 blocks on the day, and that's just impressive from her. But and with that, let's just go ahead and give it to you. Who was our player of the game?
Well, everyone expected Ewing last night, and we called it Ewing. Tonight, everyone expects Williams. We just talked about the very, very impressive stats from Jalencia Williams. 18 points, phenomenal. 2 assists, not a stat she gets very often, but hey, getting 2 assists can make a big impact on a team.
Very true.
She had 12 rebounds out of Union's 40. She had over 25% of their team rebounds, mm-hmm. and she had 6 blocks. That's virtually unheard of in women's basketball to get 6 blocks in a basketball game.
Remember, she led the Gulf South Conference in blocks last season, so she definitely is one of those big-time defensive players. Now, we also had some other good players from the Union side. Who would be our not our winner, but our highest nominee for second place?
Yeah, well, if we had to give out that kind of award, it would have to go to Lucas.
It would.
Last night, we saw Lucas really, really struggle. She had 5 points in the first quarter. She had a 3 to start the game and a layup the first 5 points of the game. And then she never scored again. And that's not typical for Lucas, who normally scores about 17 per game. Mm-hmm. Tonight, she had 15, a lot better. Still not as much as we kind of expect from her as a player. She's leading this offense in a lot of ways and kind of the future of this basketball team. But she also had 5 assists and 5 rebounds, so she definitely would get the honorable mention for player of the game.
I mean, she was just great. I mean, like you said yesterday, she totally disappeared. But today she was very just aggressive and attack. And you can touch on this if you want to a little bit, just the aggressiveness from Union today. They didn't play soft. She disappeared because it felt like they already had the game in the bag. They kind of lighted up a little bit toward the end there. But today, full aggression. She was out on the defensive end. But it was a great game today, and we'll be sure to see more of that in the future. But so no basketball on TV6 next weekend, but we'll be back with you Friday, January 22nd with our next telecast. But until then, I'm Jackson Milner. He is Alexander Billing. Have a great week, and stay tuned for To Tell the Truth.
How would you like to grow up in this family of stooges? One of these three women did. Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Joan Howard Mora.
Number two.
My name is Joan Howard Mora.
Number three.
My name is Joan Howard Mora.
Only one of these people is the real Joan Howard Mora and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now let's meet our panel. Excellent raconteur Orson Bean. From Santa Barbara, Robin Mattson. Voted America's top stand-up comedian, Dennis Wolford. And to tell the truth's very own, Kitty Carlisle. Here's the host of To Tell the Truth, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Burton. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning and welcome to our show. And good morning,
good
panel.
Good morning, good morning.
Let's get to our first story. This one looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Represented by these three women, all of whom claim to be Joan Howard Maurer. Follow along, please, as I read the affidavit. I, Joan Howard Maurer, lived with the famous Three Stooges. My father was Moe, and my uncles were Shemp and Curly. The original Stooges were Moe, Shemp, and Larry Fine. Uncle Curly joined the act in 1933. Moe's spittoon haircut, Larry looking like a scared porcupine, and Curly's shiny bald head would delight millions with head bops, fingers poked in the eyes, and Curly's nyuk, nyuk, nyuk. At home, Moe was serious and a real family man. Curly, on the other hand, was married four times and was the off-screen clown of the group. I have fond memories of Uncle Curly gracefully approaching the diving board, leaping out into space, and doing a pool-emptying cannonball. With all due respect to my father, Moe, and my uncle, Shemp, Curly was the super stooge and has become a cult hero. In fact, superstar Michael Jackson admired him so much, he wrote the foreword of my book entitled Curly. Signed, Joan Howard Maurer. More about this woman who was born into a family of Stooges following this commercial break. This item is going to bring back wonderful memories of my youth. All three of these women claim to be Joan Howard Maurer, whose father and uncles were the Three Stooges. Kitty, you started off for us.
Thank you. Number one, what happened to Larry?
Well, Larry died in 1975.
Number two, your father, Moe, was he with the Stooges all the time?
Yes, he was.
Number three, who invented the act?
Well, originally the Stooge idea came from Ted Healy, who had a couple of people as foils, and he took on the two, and ultimately it became the three.
Number two,
Let's go to Dennis for the next question.
Number two, how many children were in your family? Did your dad Moe have?
One other beside myself.
Number one, what's your favorite of the Three Stooges movies?
I have so many. I really have never picked a favorite because they have different meanings for me. So some depending upon the time of the life that the movie was done and others that just because they were so good.
And number three, what was the last time they worked together as a team?
There was a feature made at Fox, and I'm sorry, I'm blanking on the name of it.
Right.
All right, Robin, your question.
Number two, it seems kind of unusual that the three brothers lived together. What were the circumstances under which you all lived in the same house?
We didn't live in the same house.
Oh, I guess I'm taking this too literally then. Where was the house located? Where did you live? Where did you grow up?
Different homes, but part of the time in the valley.
Number one, did they work out a lot of different routines in the house? Did they get together and rehearse?
No, not at the house. They basically, our family life was kept pretty separate from the professional life.
Number three,
Orson will have to
Number
ask
three,
the
who invented? Who invented that?
Curly himself. Curly really was the most imaginative of the three. My dad was the business person.
I love the Three Stooges. Number one, what connection does Joe Besser have with your family?
Well, Joe took Curly's place, Uncle Curly's place, after Uncle Curly had his stroke.
And number two, who was the last bald member of the group?
Joe DeRita.
All right, number three.
Oh, time's up, panel. Fascinating story, isn't it? Fun, too. It's time now for you to vote for the woman you feel is the one who was related to the Three Stooges. Is it number one, is it number two, or is it number three? A team of challengers will receive $500 for each incorrect vote, with a minimum guarantee of $1,000. And if the panel is fooled completely, the team receives $3,000. Kitty, you're smiling. That's great. This whole routine makes us laugh.
I loved seeing the Three Stooges. That was brought back such happy memories. They were all very good. I have no idea, but I voted for number two.
All righty. Dennis?
I thought they were also terrific, and I also, like Kitty, have no idea. Kitty's been asking me which questions to ask, by the way, but that's another story. Number one, when she said Uncle Curly, there seemed to be a ring of truth, and so I went with number one.
Number one. All right. Robin.
Number three sounded so familiar with everything. It all seemed to roll off her tongue.
Yeah.
And when she said she couldn't think of the last movie that they were in together, it just seemed very real. So I picked number three.
Okay, a vote for realism. Orson, you're going to break the tie.
I think the movie was The Three Stooges Go to Mars. It was some science fiction picture, wasn't it? Anyway, I voted for number three. She looks like she's got that wacky family background in her eye.
We'll find out in a few moments. Right now, let's review the votes. We have one for number one, one for number two, and two for number three. And it's time now to find out which of these ladies is really related to the Three Stooges. And so will the real Joan Howard Maurer please stand up? I think it's number two, and it is. Yes. Joan, we'll get back to you in a few moments. Our imposters were terrific. Once again today, three incorrect votes. Number one, who are you?
My name is Dolores Raymaker, and I'm an attorney in Torrance, California, doing primarily family law practice.
How did you enjoy this bit? This was fun, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Pretending. Number three, what about you, ma'am?
My name is Ina Newell Bliss. I'm a former elementary school teacher and an international traveler.
Well, good for you. Three incorrect votes, as I mentioned, at $500 each. That means the team will receive $1,500. And now, Joan, you mentioned that Curly had been married four times and he was the wild one. We have some film here of one of his weddings. Which wedding was this?
The wedding to the second wife, Elaine Ackerman.
So this goes back to 1939, is it?
Right.
All right, perhaps you can tell us some of the characters that we are seeing.
Oh, we're seeing my grandfather in the middle, and my dad and Shemp to the right. The bride is Elaine Ackerman. You see them kissing her, and Curly is next to her. That's Larry, with his hair combed down rather.
We're not used to seeing him that way.
No, not at all. And there I am, mugging for the camera. And my grandmother, and there I am again.
In spite of all their antics, one last question. In spite of all their antics and all of the rough stuff we have seen on film, you get the impression watching The Three Stooges that there was a lot of love there, was there?
Yes, there really was.
Good, that's nice to know. Well, thank you so much for being with us today and bringing back these wonderful memories.
You're certainly welcome. On to Tell the Truth.
Friends, I'd like to have a conversation just one-on-one with you, because you may have a problem that many other people have. Recently, my good friend Lydia Smith and also another good friend, Cindy Wagster, came to me and they said they were really dealing with a problem. Lydia said, "There are just days that I just don't know if I want to even get up in the morning." And Cindy said to me, "I get to a point where it's about 2:00 in the afternoon and I just can't hardly go." You may be the same kind. And that means you may need Geritol. Geritol, the high potency tonic that has twice the iron in a whole pound of calf's liver. Geritol that has the complete 100% minimum daily requirement of iron for your system. What people like Lydia and Cindy may be suffering from is called tired blood. If you have tired blood, it just means that you need more energy, and it may be that you have a lack of iron. So take it from me, and also from people like Patty Simmons, another friend, who said, "I took Geritol, and I went out, I felt so good, I went out and got a complete new wardrobe, and now I have finery that I can show everybody." I also heard from another good friend, Geritol is the tonic to help you feel stronger fast, just one tablespoon a day. Years ago, they said, it'll work in 7 days or your money back. They don't say that anymore. You just have to try it for yourself and see. Geritol.
We'll be be back to play one-on-one right after this. Let's see if someone in our studio audience can win some cash. Who do you have for us today, Bert,
today,
to play
Alex,
one-on-one?
Today it is Louise Martineau from San Diego, California.
Hello, Louise.
Hello, Alex.
You came north to get the dough, huh?
Yes.
All right, good luck to you. Let me introduce a woman who has two fascinating stories to tell. Folks, please welcome Mia Lancaster. Now, Louise, you know the drill. She's going to tell us two stories, only one of which happens to be true. You spot the true story, and you have earned $500 in cash. Okay. Mia, your first story, please.
I won a look-alike contest. I look like my cat.
Oh, yeah? Fascinating story, but it may be a lie. Let's listen to story number two. Mia?
I run a taxi service called Babes. All my drivers are former models.
All right, Louise, to help you, we have one question from each member of our panel on each story. Let's start with the one that the lady says she looks like her cat, Kitty.
What was the nearest look-alike in the contest that you won?
Next to me? Well, there were no runners-up. They didn't have runners-up.
I see. Dennis?
What kind of cat do you have?
A domestic short hair.
Robin?
Where was the contest held?
New York City.
Orson?
I have a cat named Hitler.
Uh-oh.
A domestic short hair. Looks like Hitler. Number three. Now, I assume you love your cat, but are you ever bothered with hairballs?
Well, I am not, but of course, my kitty sometimes is, so she gets the appropriate remedy, which is petrol mold.
I see. Well, there's a plug for a product on our program. Louise, you heard the questioning on that story. Now we'll get to story number two, the fact that Mia runs a taxi service called Babes. Kitty.
Are your drivers allowed to date their passengers?
No, I don't have any hard and fast rules on that, but the fact is that they usually don't. I mean, they simply don't.
Dennis?
Do any of your drivers speak English?
They all speak English.
Okay, these are attractive women out there picking up customers all times of the day and night. Now, what do they do for extra security precautions?
Well, they all live in New York, so they know how dangerous it can be. All of my fleet of cabs have grating, usually plexiglass or some other kind of grating.
That'll help Louise in the audience. Orson?
Do your drivers get better tips than the usual dirty old men that drive people around?
Well, I hope so. I actually don't ask them, but they very well might.
All right.
All right, Louise, you have heard the cross-examination. Two great stories. But you tell us, in order to win $500, does Mia look like her cat, or does she run a taxi service?
Well, it's a difficult choice, but my instincts tell me the first one, the cat look-alike contest.
All righty. Mia Lancaster, what's your true story?
To tell the truth, I do look like my cat.
All righty. Congratulations, Louise. That's $500 coming your way. Thank you for playing one-on-one. Mia. What's your cat's name?
My kitty's name is Ariel.
Ariel, how did you get it?
I adopted her 3.5 years ago when she was 6 months old.
And you're still in the business of looking for homeless cats, right?
Well, I have five other kitties at home making six permanent babies to me and all. And I run a tiny little shoestring organization in New York called Place for Cats. We rescue strays and we try to find responsible homes for them. Unfortunately, it's very hard because there are 24 million unwanted strays every year in the United States, and we're only able to find about 100 good homes a year. So,
all right. Well,
we work hard.
As long as the adoptive people don't have to look like the cats, that'll make it a lot easier.
Yes.
We'll be back, and you'll meet Mia and Ariel after this. For our prize winners, Ariel and Mia and all the rest of us here on the program, thank you for watching To Tell the Truth today. We'll look for you tomorrow. So long.
This is Brendan Richardson speaking for To Tell the Truth, a Mark Goodson television production.